Hello and thanks for staying with us. I'm Todd McDermott.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. A tragic accident in Loxahatchee from over the weekend. A three-year-old boy was run over by his father in their driveway.
Aaron Guy went back to the house today. And Aaron, I know you spoke with the little boy's grandmother.
Todd and Tiffany, this is just heartbreaking. I sat down with little Michael Pollard's grandmother, or as she calls him, Pie. And as you can imagine, she is living her worst nightmare. She says that one of her biggest concerns is little Pie's older brother, who watched the whole thing unfold.
But this is what he loved.
Yeah.
This comfort, little comfort.
Michelle Alimanti holds on to three-year-old Michael's favorite teddy bear. She's grandma to these two little boys.
Accidents happen, and it's just so unfortunate. The loss on so many people. I mean, on me, it's just very empty right now.
Sunday, the unthinkable happened. Little Michael ran behind this big Ford truck. His father was behind the wheel.
They are devastated, and I'm just sick over it.
By the time Michael made it to the hospital, he had died.
I worry about his brother because they spent so much time together. He would go to the refrigerator, get himself a drink, and he would always bring his brother out one. I never will forget that. I thought that was just so kind.
And his six-year-old big brother, who you see here trying to comfort his dad after the accident, saw everything.
It's going to be a really tough road, and we're going to make sure he gets the help he needs.
This family is now trying to figure out what's next. They're planning a service and hoping to donate Michael's organs.
It would be nice to know that we can help other people out who have small children that have been in some kind of an injury that could use a living part. And in some way, in my heart, I would feel like at least he's living.
For now, the family's trying to cope, comprehend the loss, and remember the little boy that was so giving, kind, and full of love.
Very active, very full of life and love, very loved, very sweet boy.
That was not an easy interview to do. You feel for that family, and they tell me again they are still working to organize these services. Now, I did reach out to the sheriff's office. They said they did a full investigation. They're calling this a horrific and just unfortunate accident. Live in the newsroom, Aaron Guy, WPBF 25 News.